You saw the Warriors game last night and what happened with Durant. Gruden was talking about how last year he saw you try to pop your shoulder back in to get out there and play. You wound up on injured reserve. I'm just curious as to what's a professional athlete's mindset on when they should go out and try and play. Do you need the medical staff to tell you not to? Is it going to be up to you? How do you kind of sort through that whole thing?
I just feel like at the end of the day, we're all doing a game that we love, which is, I mean, ever since we were little kids, we were always being able to compete. And we're going to be competitors at the end of the day. So even when you feel like you have a little nicked up or do this or do that, you just want to be able to continue to be out there with your team, just giving your all. And I mean, whether it is an actual injury or you just feel like you're hurt a little, you just want to still be able to go out there and play. And I mean, sometimes when it's a real injury, the training staff, they'll stop you. But I mean, when you feel like you can go, you're definitely going to try.
Would you have played last year, the last couple of weeks, if you were in a playoff situation, or you just couldn't go?
Yes.
Yes, I
felt like I definitely felt like I wanted to, even though we weren't in a playoff situation. I mean, just to be able to continue to play and go out and compete each week was something I definitely wanted to do.
So they IR'd you basically against your wishes?
Yes.
Which game was it where you popped out
the shoulder? I believe it was Cincinnati.
Okay. And then you were IR'd the next week too.
How did you grow in last year, just from a mature standpoint, and whether that's on the field, off the field, anything between?
Well, I mean, just having another year of life under my belt, it just you continue to learn and get better. I mean, and on the field and off the field, I feel like on the field, just being able to just be a guy that's reliable. I mean, as far as the coaches, my teammates, and just being everywhere that's expected of me.
I think the coaching staff showed a lot of confidence in you, especially as the season went on. How did that do for your confidence in coming into the season?
It just sets the bar high, and I mean you be able to hit the ground running. When we got back here in the spring, we talked with coaches. We knew what was going to be expected of us. So being able to come in and just take off from where we left off, it was a great high point.
John has said there's a different vibe this year. What's your sense of it so far this offseason, the moves you guys made, what you've seen so far?
I feel like it's definitely way ahead of where it was last year. And I mean, from the guys that we had on the team last year that we brought back into the team, it's basically just all vibing off of one another. The additions that we've had, those guys, I mean, we have some top notch players, and I mean they come in and they're taking on the role that's expected of them as well. And I mean it's all gelling very well.
Working with Gareon the last year plus and getting to know him. Is he a real sky's the limit type of player? How do you view his game and his work ethic?
Definitely. I think Gareon's going to have an amazing season. I mean, that's simply off the field. We're actually staying together right now. So I mean, we've got a lot closer off the field as far as everything goes. But I mean, he's a guy that's no matter what you expect out of him, he's going to continue to set the bar high and compete for himself.
I feel like that's something that can translate onto the field. I mean, the time that you guys are now spending off the field.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. When did that arrangement start, living together?
Since spring. So when did we start spring? April, like 17th, something around there.
How's that been?
It's fun. I mean, you know, it kind of takes you back to your college days, even though you're grown men living with another grown man. But it's cool. I mean, as long as no one's messy, I feel like you never have a problem.
Have you been without a roommate for a while? Is this new for you?
Yeah, I mean, the last roommate I had is my fiance right now. So no, I haven't had another one. I haven't had one before that since like sophomore year of college.
Yeah.
Raiders have kind of a history of having like a couple of really good corners, and you can go back to Haynes and Hayes and whatnot. Do you kind of envision you and Conley being a pair like that for the Raiders?
Yes, definitely, and that's something that Coach Gruden has been emphasizing to us this year. I mean, we're at that point in our careers where it's the prime, and we really for our team to thrive, we feel as though we have to be playing at the highest clip as well.
What are your thoughts about the possibility that, I don't know, have you guys been told one way or another whether or not Hard Knocks is going to be doing you guys this year?
No, I haven't.
What would your thoughts would be? I don't know if it is, but if it was the case, what would your thoughts be?
I think it would be fun. I mean, we have a lot of new personalities, guys on the team. I mean, I don't feel like I would be like a star just because I'm not that big of a talker or anything. But yeah, it'll definitely be fun.
Do you TV cameras are here, is that reason to trim your beard or to keep it growing?
Oh, man. I probably would keep it going. Now that that would probably be a story.
Speaking of who would be the biggest star?
I mean, there's that goes without being said, AB.
Speaking of stars, you get a chance to line up and cover Antonio Brown every day. What's that doing for you, and what does his sort of energy and what he brings to practice, how's that lifted everybody else?
He's a guy that plays at a high clip. Just if you were to watch him just catch a simple slant, he takes it all the way to the end zone. He wants to score each and every play. So he's definitely a high-level competitor. And we talked to him before practice got started and everything. And the one thing he wanted to say was that we all need to get better. Not only is he going to make us better by being one of the best receivers in the league, but we're also going to make him better because we're all different players at the end of the day.
It seemed like from watching some of the early practices, like there is, after certain plays or certain routes, it seems like there's some dialogue between you and him or him and Gareon. Is that just kind of banter or is there something constructive coming out of that?
Oh no, it's definitely constructive. I mean, we ask questions because I mean he's seen a lot of different players, and we know that this offseason he actually did a little bit of studying on us and just getting ready for practice and stuff like that. So he's definitely been able to give us feedback on where he felt as though we can improve or where he felt as though that we've seen that we may have covered it well.
What's an example of something that he's suggested to you or his feedback that he's given you?
Just different releases off the line, things like that. When he feels as though a certain thing is coming, he'll attack it.
He studied up on his own corners to make them better in practice?
Yes.
Is that unusual?
Oh, man, I wouldn't say so. I mean, it's helped him thrive this long.
No, I mean, have you noticed other guys doing that, or is that something that's unique to him?
It may just have been a story where that this is the only time we've heard of it, but, I mean, it's definitely something I can see happening.
You're entering your fourth year, but you're still pretty young. Are you feeling like this is the start of your prime, that your confidence and physical ability is kind of...
Yes, I feel like it definitely has to be. I don't feel like there's any more time to waste or where I'm still beating around the bush with it. I feel like it is the prime of my career, and it's time to take it to another level.
In your secondary, it seems like there are a number of guys who are kind of coming up together. You talk about Gareon, you talk about Abram getting accustomed to the league. You know, Carl wants to take his game to the next level. What's the culture like in this secondary room, which is guys who seem to be all trying to take that next step?
I feel like the vibe in our room right now is just it's amazing. From the guys that we added on the outside, guys like Nevin and Curtis Riley coming from other teams where they weren't necessarily the top-notch tier guys, but they come in with a certain work habit, and they're showing it on and off the field. We have LJ who's come into the room. He's played a top-notch football. I mean, he just played in February, so for him to turn back around and come right into OTAs working the way that he does, and us adding the young guys, it's kind of like a good culture that's really going around with similar guys.
What was your reaction when you saw the schedule for this, especially the first half? Obviously, you guys were traveling a lot, go long stretch without playing a game here. What was just your reaction to the schedule?
I mean, it doesn't matter where you strap it up at. You have to go out there and play each and every day.
How do you feel about talking to the system now entering year two? Obviously, you have to play in it for a little bit and you got hurt. But did you feel like when you were hurt, you were able to watch from the sideline and see it unfold a little bit differently than when you were out there?
Yes, definitely. I mean, you're just being on the sideline when you know what's going on and guys are doing certain things, you begin to study and it becomes a lot more clear to you.
So for that reason, you feel like you're going to be able to advance further in the second year in Paul Gunther's system?
Yes, definitely.
Last year when you guys went to London, it was a pretty quick trip. I don't know how many hours you guys were there, but off the plane, walkthrough, game, long trip back. It sounds like this year is going to be different, where you guys can go from Indianapolis to London most likely. What are your thoughts about the extra time to acclimate, and what was it like last year with the short turnaround?
I feel like the short turnaround last year, it might have took a toll on some guys' bodies compared to being able to have a lot more time to unwind. Not so much of being a tourist, but just having that body clock, being able to be fully adjusted going into a game on Sunday.